Let us now see an example of how Word2Vec can be used to embed peptides into a vector space and followed by artificial neural network for classification. So we will start with importing the required libraries. We will need BioVec for handling our FASTA file, GenSim for creating Word2Vec, Pandas for handling data frame. So we will first import FASTA file, which will contain all the sequences. Then we will define a helper function named splitngram, which will take input a sequence and the k-mer size. So given the k-mer size, this will divide our sequences into different k-mers. For example, if we have an input sequence of AGA, MQ, SASM, and the k-mer size is 3. So it will select the first three alphabets, then the next three alphabets, and then last three alphabets. And then it will start from the second alphabet and it will do the same, and from the third alphabet and do the same. So it will return a list of list which will contain these three different k-mers. So let us see how this will perform on an example sequence. So as we can see that we have given an example sequence and it has returned a list of different k-mers. So now let us apply this function to our complete data to get the complete corpus. So our corpus will be comprised of the list of k-mers for all the sequences in our data file. So now once we have created our corpus, we can move on to creating our vectors. For creating our vectors, we will be using Word2Vec, and Word2Vec have few parameters that we will like to define initially. So the parameters we are defining here is SG equals to 1. That means that we will be using scriptgram model of Word2Vec. Next is epochs equals to 5. That means we are going to run our model for 5 iterations. Negative equals to 0 means we are not going to do any negative sampling. And HS equals to 1 means we will be using hierarchical softmax for training. So let us build our Word2Vec model. So Word2Vec model will take in the corpus which we have just created, and it will embed those sequences or those k-mers into a 100 dimensional vector with a window of size 10. So next we will define a helper function which will take in the Word2Vec model which we have just created, the sequence, and also the k-mer size, and it will embed the sequences into vectors of dimension 100. So let us now import the positive file. So this positive file will be imported in similar way as we have imported our data file for Word2Vec model. And once the sequences are extracted from the FASTA file, those sequences will be saved in a Pandas data frame. So let's see how our positive data looks like. So along with this, we have also added an activity which defines that these sequences are actually having an activity of antifungal. So next we will do same for loading, then for creating our negative data. So negative data, we have assigned class 0, which means these sequences does not have any antifungal activity. So now we will combine these, our positive and negative data. So we have combined both positive and negative data. And once we have combined this data, let us now convert all of these sequences into their respective vector dimension using the helper function which we have defined before. we have now embedded all of our 1840 sequences into an 100 dimension vector. So we can see over here. So this is our vector representation. So now we will also extract a target label. And once we have extracted a target label, we would now start, we will now get into model building. And for model validation, we are using a test train split with 20% of the of our total data as test data. So we are using Keras for building our artificial neural network. So Keras is a library which runs TensorFlow in the backend. So from this, we will be using a sequential kind of type of model with dense layer and dropout layers in between. And for initializing the weights, we will be using Glorot normal. So we will start building our model. So we will initially define what type of model it will be. So so our model is going to be sequential one. So we will initialize the sequential model. Then we will keep on adding the layers. So first we will add the dense layer with 128 neurons and ReLU as an activation. And the bias and weights are initialized with Glorot normal. So this is followed by dropout. We are dropping 40% of the neurons. This is followed by dense layer with 64 neurons and ReLU activation. Again, dropout. Then next is dense layer with 32 neurons and activation is ReLU, followed by dropout. Then the last hidden layer is having 12 neurons with activation ReLU, followed by dropout. And finally, we have an output layer where the activation is sigmoid to get the probability of being class 1 or 0. So now we will compile our model with optimizer being an atom and loss function being binary cross entropy. And the metric we would like to observe will be accuracy. So let us fit our model. And while fitting our model, we will be using batch size of 32 and we will train our model for 50 epochs. And while training, we will also do a validation split of 20%. So our model is trained. So let us see what the results we got after once our model is trained. So for this, for visualizing the results, we are using matplotlib. As we can see, we have plotted two plots. First, this first plot is plotting the loss, where the blue line represents the training loss and the orange represents the validation loss. As we can see, so both losses are reducing over the time, over the epochs, and also the validation loss is following the training loss. And similarly, we can see in accuracy that our training accuracy is increasing over the epochs and validation accuracy is also following it. So now evaluate our model on the test data, which we had initially splitted using train test split. So on our test data, we have got a loss of 0.089 and we get an accuracy of 97%.